Well, it's Sunday, October 4th, and we're proud to bring you another episode of Reading Pop Warner A Football. Your 2-1 Rockets have another stiff challenge this week with the 2-1 Drakett in the Tennessee Titans uniforms. The weather here in Reading is, it says 55 degrees, but with the wind, it probably feels more like 40 heavy winds today. I'm your play-by-play announcer, Josh Blumenschein. With me on the camera is Adam Hooker. Proud to be out and showing his face today after the Georgia Dogs took a whooping from Alabama. But we're glad to bring you this football game. Out there at midfield for the Rockets, you got 24 Lucas Lorenzo, who's on crutches today after being hurt in the last week. He's out for another week. We've got 64 Jay Kajander, 44 Jason Conroy, number 9 Evan Long. Referees are taking the coin toss here. It looks as though Reading has won the toss. Okay, so Reading won deferred. Drakett will receive the ball going from right to left on your screen. So Reading needs to bounce back today after a tough loss last week against Everett, a hard-fought game. This could be one of those trap games. You play a really tough game, you're up for it, you don't win. Are you ready the next week to face another good opponent? Reading down to 18 guys today as they swarm at the 50-yard line. Vincent Sullivan going to break it down for the Rockets.
You know, key today is these guys got to hold their blocks and get their assignments. Kind of hurt us last week. Hold on to the football.
That's right. Everybody knowing their responsibility. Ball security was an issue earlier today in the B game, Reading against Drakett also. Reading turned it over about four times, including on their last drive, and they wound up losing 7-6. But, you know, you think that if you can just hold on to the ball, some of those drives are going to result in points.
Yeah, they were moving the ball very efficient.
And I know these Rockets have heard it from Coach all week, and they reviewed it on game tape yesterday. Hold on to the ball.
Yeah, and I was over at the walkthrough this morning, and they were sleepwalking. So I hope they come out with a little fire today.
Come out with that passion. Christian Chauger, number 43, Rockets kicker to get things started here. The way he tees it up makes you think it might be an onside kick. Let's take a look here. There we go. The ball's on the ground. And it's loose, and the Rockets may have it at the 47. A great way to start the game. A well-executed onside kick got through the first man. Rockets will take over on the 47 to start the game.
It's a good start.
Excellent, excellent start. I didn't see who got the ball. Did you, Adam?
No, I couldn't tell. It looks like there was about three guys on that.
Yep. Colin Duros breaks the huddle, number 22. Got big Chris Chuli anchoring the line at center, 84. B.J. Jemelaro to the left guard. There's the snap. Colin pitches to Brendan DeSilva. There's a huge convoy of blockers. The block by Dan McGrath sprees him down the sideline. He could go all the way for a touchdown on the first play from scrimmage. Brendan DeSilva, number 10, took the sweep pitch from Colin and went all the way.
Wow, McGrath really laid a block on that.
That freed him up on the outside, number 12, with a great downfield block. That is the way to start a football game.
Absolutely.
Reading comes out lining up for the one-point extra point try. In the backfield, Duros and McGrath and DeSilva. Oh, he takes it himself. Colin Duros out to the left. He's looking to throw. He gets it away for the touchdown to Jay Kajander, number 64. On the extra point, they convert. So it's 7-0. Well-executed pass play there. Rolling to his left, able to throw across the body and complete the pass, Colin. Well, that is the way to start. Whether or not they were sleepwalking in practice, they came out ready to play here in the opening minutes. Christian Chauger sets the ball up here on the 40. Ready for the kickoff. On the coverage, you got Zupan, you got Thomas Keene, Matt Hammond, Jack Blumenschein, Colin DuRoss. The kick goes down the middle of Squibber. Fielded there at the 26-yard line by number two for Drakett. He's contained in the outside, so he cuts it back the other way, looking for a seam. He's finally brought down by a couple Rockets. I see Matt Hammond was the first there, number 50. Brendan DeSilva, number 10, also helped clean it up. So that's at the 38.5-yard line where Drakett will take over. On that kickoff, you saw what you were talking about at the outset, Adam. There was good coverage. Everybody knew their lane, stayed in their lane. You know, the cutbacks, he couldn't find anywhere to run. Everybody was in their lane, so. Number 23, Matt Gorman, comes on out, call the defense here. Oh, and Vince Sullivan comes on, number 14. He'll be in the A-gap along with number 32, Don DiCrescenzo. There's the snap. Oh, he pitches it to number 15 deep, and he is tackled 8 yards, 9 yards behind the line of scrimmage. There was a bit of miscommunication there, some confusion on the play for Drakett. The quarterback thought he was going to pitch it one way and instead went back the other. So that's second and 18 now from the 32-yard line. In the I formation, quarterback takes from under center. He pitches right there early on. Jay Kajander with B.J. Jemelar helping him finish off another huge loss for Drakett. They are going backwards to the 20-yard line. That brings up third and 29 yards. They're down now for Drakett. Now they're in the shotgun. Reading Rockets getting penetration there on the line. The snap to 57. He goes on the left-hand side. He's met immediately. He's going to lose 2 yards there. Looks like B.J. Jemelaro in the tackle, wearing the pink sleeves and pink socks for Breast Cancer Awareness Month here in October. Drakett going the wrong direction. Fourth down. They're going to look to punt here from the 19. Back deep for the Reading Rockets is number 10, Brendan DeSilva. In the punt formation, he gets a great punt. Brendan's going to let it go. It's going to roll out of bounds at the 40-yard line.
Wow.
Still, yeah, it was a huge, huge punt by that punter. Rockets have enough faith in their offense. They didn't need the punt return there. Rockets come to the line. Number 70, Lucas Barbeau, Zach Barbeau on the line. The snap goes to Dan McGrath. He breaks the initial tackle. He breaks another tackle. It gets all the way down to the 36-yard line. A pickup of 18 yards on first down. Good hard running by Dan McGrath. They've got a big lineup in right now, the Rockets. Seeing something different for the Rockets now. Jay Kajander, 64, is snapping for the Rockets. Chris Julie's over there at left tight end. Jack Blumenschein wing back on the left, and Matt Hammond out from there. There's the snap to Colin DuRoss. He's got room around the left-hand side. He's got blockers in front of him. Dan McGrath gets a chip. Colin's still on his feet. He's down the sideline. He's in for the touchdown unless he stepped out. The referee is signaling touchdown. Great run around the left-hand side, going for 37 yards on the touchdown. Colin DuRoss, that makes it 13-0 Rockets. So the Rockets appear to be coming out for the one-point extra point try. Up 13-0 after two drives here in the first quarter. McGrath and DuRoss in the backfield. Matt Hammond is... Oh, right up the middle. The whole Drakett team was in the end zone. They're not going to stop it on that play like that. I think Reading is getting that push on the line. Number 14, Vinny Sullivan. Number 70, Zach Barbeau. Number 65, Trevor Zupan. 84, Chris Julie, 54, Ben Mason, 32, Dime DiCrescenzo. Big blocks there right now. Drake, it's in there. Yeah, they're going backward.
They offered absolutely no resistance on that.
No resistance. 14-0 Reading Rockets. Right now, Drake, it looks like they don't know what hit them. Here comes Christian Chauger for the kick. He boots it deep. Number 25 catches it, but he drops it. It's picked up there by number 15. He runs around to the right-hand side, and there's an arm tackle. He gets through it. 44, Jason Conroy brings him down at the 31-yard line. Way to wrap him up and bring him down. Well, as Reading Rockets help Ben Mason off the field, number 54, appears to be favoring that ankle. That would be a big loss for the Rockets. He's a stalwart there on the line. Rockets already down to 18 players today before that loss. Looks like the Reading defense is not completely ready. I mean, they're still helping Mason off the field, and Drake was lined up ready to play. That'll be interesting. All right, Rockets come out on defense here. BJ centering the middle linebacker there. There's a snap, but it's a fake pass, and 14 gets up the middle before brought down by BJ Gemellaro after a gain of about 3 or 4. Yeah, it's going to bring up 2nd and 6. Last drive for Drake, they went backwards.
First positive play there.
Look at that play. The pass was caught, but BJ was in there wrestling that ball away. You're keeping an eye on the game, right? 1st and 10 for Drake on the 48-yard line of Reading. They completed the pass there in the middle. It was a jump ball. BJ had a hand on it too, but Drake, a player, came down with it. 1st and 10. Snap by the shotgun. Number 14 looks to throw. He's got a man deep. Number 87. He's looking for it. He's caught it. Number 9, Evan Long, trying to bring him down. He wrestles the ball all the way down to the 4-yard line. Drake, it has a passing game. Number 87, big tight end. He can make those catches. And they're going to be in 1st and goal from the 4. All of a sudden, the Rockets have a game here.
That was a nice throw and catch.
Beautiful throw. Trickett spreads 4 wide receivers out to the right now. Like a quad formation, I guess. And 14's under center. He looks to run it up the middle. He's not going to get anywhere with that play.
Yeah, he ran right into the teeth of the defense on that.
Well, Reading with good gap control, you're not going to usually find a hole up the middle like that.
No.
Right now in the trenches, we've got 23 Matt Gorman and 40 Thomas Keene in the A gap, 84 Chris Julian and 32 Dom DiCrescenzo. Those boys are well trained, well drilled to control the line of scrimmage. This time, Drake splits 2 wide receivers out to the right and a T formation backfield there. The snap goes to the right back, 57, and he breaks through a hole. He's in for the touchdown. Drake, it's on the board, 14-6.
Right up the
middle. Drake, it's going to attempt the 2-point kicking extra point here, number 49. There's a snap, it's high, and he's smothered by number 10, Brendan Da Silva, who streaked through the line. The snap was a little high and the holder couldn't get it down in time. So it's 14-6 Reading, about halfway through the first quarter, according to the clock. Redding's ready for the kick here now. It's an onside kick. It has not made it anywhere close to 10 yards. Yeah, That onside kick only made it about 7 yards, and it's going to be down there. Reading ball at the 47 of Draken.
You know, good discipline by the Rockets there not to go after that ball.
That's right. Here we go, first and 10 for the Rockets. 73, Jack Blumenschein wide left. Number 9, Evan Long in the slot. On the right-hand side here, we've got 22, DuRoss in the slot. And he motions. The handoff from Brendan De Silva. Plenty of room down the field. He's able to get about 9 yards on the carry where he's brought down at the 37. Nifty play there, the jet sweep from the slot man in motion.
And they're just picking up chunks of yards right now.
And 10 Rockets now. Same formation. 43 Christian Trauger split out wide right.
Coming back to this side.
Snap the Evan Long takes it, cuts it up the middle. He's able to go out three or four before he's arm tackled, wrestled down finally by Drakett. Looks like they're only giving him two on the spot. Second and 8. Reading Rockets, 2nd and 8. DuRoss in motion. The fake. Brendan Silva takes it himself along the right-hand side. He's able to drag defenders down to the 29-yard line, setting up a manageable 3rd and 2. The blocks on that right side by Dom DiCrescenzo and Zach Barbo help free that up. 3rd and 2. Third and 2, hope they keep it on the ground here and don't try and pass out of this formation. What do you say? Let's get that first down.
Sweep to the left.
McGrath motions. Oh. There's the snap. He's going to follow McGrath's block. De Silva, he's got a big hole. He's going to go all the way in for the touchdown. Brendan De Silva. Once they get into that second level, there's no bringing him down. He's got so long and fast, long strides. Usually with the blockers in front of him. Dan McGrath was down there as well.
Problem was Dan didn't even have to hit anyone.
He didn't have to. The kid ran away from the hit.
Can't say I blame him.
Gets out of hand. Redding breaks the huddle for the 1 point extra point try. 20-6 right now. DuRoss motions to the right or left. The snap to De Silva. He's got a hole. He goes over the left-hand side. Wow, the official's saying no. It looked like he went over the tackle into the end zone, but they're not giving him the extra point. So 20-6, up 2 scores. The clock still says it's the first quarter. Well, we start the second quarter now here, and Redding has scored at the end of the first quarter to make it 20-6. They come out here now for the kickoff. Back deep for the Drakett Titans. I want to call them the Titans. Number 2. Here's the kick from Trauger. He boots it down the middle. And right to number 2. BJ breaks through one block. He's still on his feet. He's brought down by DuRoss and McGrath at about midfield. Good return by the Titans player. Of course, what happens is when that ball comes at you quickly like that and you field it cleanly, you have more time to spot your blocks and get upfield, get some momentum. Yeah, that is good. Good sign. Number 14 for Drake. It breaks the huddle. Not a big player, but pretty crafty. They've got this weird formation where they have 4 backs over here on the right-hand side, and he throws it deep on a little bubble screen. It's a backward pass. Number 2 throws the ball up. No one sees it. They're going to call a flag on Brendan De Silva. There was no way that number 57 was going to come back and catch that ball.
Oh, that's an uncatchable pass.
That ball was a pop-up to first base.
I think the only thing they probably get him on is a hold.
So on that play, the quarterback threw the ball backwards, a backwards lateral, and the other Drakett player looked to throw it deep, but didn't really have the arm for it. But they're going to pick up a first down here on the play. of 15 yards. So they did call pass interference. Tough call.
Yeah.
35-yard line now for Drakett. Zach Barbo's got the play for the Rockets defense there in the A gap. Here comes number 14.
A little confusion in the backfield.
That's right. He's under center. Two backs in the backfield here. He's going to hand it up the middle, and he's brought down immediately. No gain. A little bit of push on the left-hand side there by Zach Barbo. So a small lot, well, actually, just to give him no gain on the play. Second down. Zupanon, long off for the Rockets there on the left corner. Jason Conroy's got the right corner locked up. In tight with a wing back, two tight end formation. 14, he drops back to pass. He gets the ball up. No one home. The coverage there by Jason Conroy. And third down. Break it. See what they have in their bag of tricks. The quad right formation again. And quarterback number 14 in the shotgun. The pass, number 29, the ball's on the ground.
That's a backwards pass.
They're calling it incomplete. Oh. It did look at the last minute as if the quarterback was deeper than the lateral. So that bring up fourth down from the 35. They're calling for the punt for Drakett. De Silva back to field it. I'm sure that if it's over, he's going to let it go. It's a high punt, booming punt by 86. Let it go, Brennan, let it go. All right, well, not the way you draw that up, but he did field it at the 10.
He just didn't want to get stuck behind the 5. Oh.
You know, as he was chasing down the bouncing ball, he looked to put a hit on the punt coverage before finally falling on it. So. And coach is describing the error of his ways on that one. So, first and 10 for the Rockets here on the 11-yard line. Good sign for the Rockets as Ben Mason, number 54, is back in. Dan McGrath takes the play call from coach. With the wind picking up right now, it might be a good idea to keep the ball on the ground. Matt Hammond splits wide left. All right, they're following the blocks on the left-hand side. Dan McGrath runs through one man, still on his feet, gets all the way down to the 20. There was good blocking there. The seal on the edge by Jack Blumenschein, as well as good blocks along the line. And that's a first down carry for Dan McGrath. On the line right now here, right tackle DeCrescenzo, right guard Ben Mason, Jay Kajander at center, Vince Sullivan left guard, Zach Barbo left tackle. There's the snap to Colin Duras over right tackle. He's got a big hole. He's still on his feet after a pickup of 16 yards, brought down at the 38-yard line. Everybody making their blocks and holding their blocks. First and 10 Rockets from the 37. There's the snap, Dan McGrath. follows the block. Oh, they slipped through. He's able to cut it up and get positive yardage, about three on the carry. Drake had that well defended, but still a positive carry for the Rockets on first down. Most of these Rockets running backs, it's going to take more than one defender to bring him down. Dan McGrath, certainly no exception. Colin DuRoss back there, he takes the snap, fouls on the right-hand side. He's got a hole up the middle. He busts it up for about a 6-7 yard carry. It looks like he might have first down yardage. Third and about a foot for the Rockets here as they break the huddle. Ball's at the 47-yard line. There's the snap. Oh, Dan McGrath, stiff arm, and he gets outside. He's got the first down and more. Down over the 40-yard line.
I think he definitely looks for defenders to hit.
Brings a linebacker's mentality
Absolutely.
To running back.
You know, he plays baseball the same way he plays football. Basketball, the kid's all out.
Rockets break the huddle here at the 40-yard line. This drive began back at their own 10. They've picked up 50 yards so far, and they're still on the march, chewing up the rest of the second quarter, up 20-6. De Silva back in the game at quarterback. There's the snap. No, he's going to throw. He's got a man. Matt Hammond, oh, off his hands at the 20. Looked like he was going to run, but he stepped back, and he unleashed a beautiful pass. The play was there. Matt Hammond got down the field. Second down and 10. Good to keep him honest. Let him know that we can throw it a little bit too.
Absolutely.
I hope not. Second and 10 for the Rockets. Brendan De Silva follows on the right-hand side. The line's been pushed. He's got a man downfield. He's still on his feet. He got a block from McGrath. He gets all the way down to about the 13-yard line. A beautiful run over the right tackle. And what I saw there was a push on that whole right side of the line, 5 yards down the field, still maintaining their blocks.
Absolutely.
Good lane to run for Brendan De Silva.
You know, they held their blocks, too.
They held their blocks. First and 10 for the Rockets. From the 14-yard line. Vinny Sullivan in the backfield with Brendan De Silva. He's on for Dan McGrath. The snap and the handoff to Vinny, and he's up the middle. That's that push in the back handoff from Brendan De Silva that he likes to do so much. Did they get any yards on that? Maybe a yard?
Maybe.
Half the Rockets on, half off. Wholesale change here. Christian Chagger split out wide right. There's the snap to DuRoss. The hand to De Silva. He's got a big hole on the right-hand side. Still on his feet. He gets down close to first down yardage. There's a flag on the play. An illegal shift by the Rockets. So that'll set us back 5 yards. Second and 15 coming up. Okay. Now they've stepped it off. There we go.
Not sure what the discussion was there.
Second and 15. Took a little while to resolve. McGrath is deep. DuRoss back with De Silva. There's the snap. The handoff to Dan McGrath. He fouls over left-hand side. He's able to move forward. There's another flag on the play. Not much of a gain, maybe 3 yards. We'll see what the laundry's about.
Yeah, it looks like he got a hold.
Yeah.
it on back five more. Oh, no flag.
Oh, they're picking up the flag here. That should bring up third down. Rockets in the 19-yard line. They've got to get to the three for a first down. Trying to get one more score before the half. The snap to DeRoss. He's got Da Silva over in the left-hand side. Good blocks downfield. They just took out that poor guy. He's down to about the 4-yard line, very close to first down yardage. Blocks downfield by Jamilaro McGrath. Jason Conroy out there providing some blocking as well. So with fourth down here, does he elect to kick the field goal or go for the first down? He's got 3 yards to get the first.
I think you run it here.
You got him on the run, the 6-yard line. Never a hesitation in Coach Geiger's head. He sends out DeRoss with the play.
Yeah, if you don't make it, they have to go the length of the field in a minute 35.
Yeah, it's not going to happen. There's a penalty. Could be a delay game.
Yep.
So it makes it fourth and eight. Charger split way out wide right. Motioning by Evan Long. And DeRoss right up the middle. He's still on his feet. He charges through. He's close to the goal line. At the very least, he's got the first. Right up the middle, down to the 1-yard line. Timeout by the Rockets. They've got Vinny, the secret weapon in the backfield. My money's on him getting the ball here.
Another bush push right here.
1 yard to go. 1 yard to glory. The snap to Silva, he hands it to Vinny Sullivan. Over the right-hand side, he's in for the touchdown! Great blocking. Great run by Vinny. Makes it 26-6, Rockets. All right, for the one-pointer, go up 21 points. The handoff to Thomas Keene on the right-hand side. He's not going to get there. Ball's on the ground, still live. No, they whistle it dead. So the extra 26-6 here. Clock says there's a minute left in the half. Here's the kick. It's a deep kick. It's over number two's head. He picks it up at the 20. He's on the run. He makes a move and gets outside. He's still on his feet. Charger's there to bottle him up. Still running. He moves out to the left-hand side. He's being chased. A group of Rockets finally pull him down at the 49-yard line.
Nice return.
It was a good return. He picked it up off of the bounce and kept going. So that exciting return ends the first half with the score of Reading Rockets 26 and Drake at 6. Four scores for the Rockets in the first half. Very efficient offense. Scored every time they touched the ball, I think. One good drive by Drakett, and they can move the ball a little bit through the air mostly. But Reading Rockets are really getting the push on the line, both offensive and defensive. So no reason to think that Drakett will come back in the second half. A little coverage of the Rocket cheerleaders here perhaps now.
Yeah.
Yeah. So as we get ready to start the second half, already up 26-6, the Rockets get to receive the ball first. If you remember, in the first half, the opening kickoff was an onside kick that they recovered. So back deep right now, you got Jemilaro, number 7, and DeSilver, number 10, with the up block there, up man of Dan McGrath. There's the boot. Good kick up in the air. Caught on the run by Brendan DeSilver at the 28. He follows BJ's block. Cuts up the middle. He's past midfield. He's over the 40. He's still on his feet, down to the 35. Great way to start the half for the Reading Rockets.
Nice return.
Caught it on the run and was able to make good yardage. We're getting close to that point of the game where, you know, blowout rules start to come into effect. One more score here for the Rockets.
So maybe where you use the opportunity to try a few things you normally don't do.
Yep. Having long in motion. The snap is high to DeRoss, but he corrals it right up the gut. No, not even touched for a touchdown, 35 yards. He was up the middle like a rocket.
Or you just keep doing what you've been doing. That was a nice run.
Great blocking. I mean, he was not touched. He had Chris Julie there in the center, getting that snap and getting a good block. But certainly DeRoss ran hard and made it count. So it's 32-6 Rockets. Going for the one-pointer here with up 26. The snap to DeRoss. There's a flag on the play. False start on the Rockets.
Looks like whoever's on the right side of that line jumped.
Mm. So a little bit more complex conversion here from the 8-yard line. The snap, the 22, he takes it around. DeRoss, he's out there. He's looking for a pass. He's got a man. Oh, it was to DeCrescenzo. He didn't get his hands up in time, so it falls incomplete, 32-6. Here come the Rockets. Ryan Christian Trager. He gives it a big boot up the middle. One hop, it bounces at number 2's feet. Being chased there, able to make a move. Brought down by Dan McGrath, a good hard tackle at the 36. When he hits these guys, they feel it.
And he always seems to be around the ball.
Around the ball. He puts that hit on and he wraps too. Pretty sure tackler. Drake at ball now. Number 2 split out wide right. I formation in the backfield. Under center, 14 flips to the deep back. Number 15 over the left-hand side. He's able to get a couple yards before he's wrapped up there. In on the play, Matt Hammond, number 50. Second down. Second down and about 8 yards for Drake it. In the pink socks. And the Titans uniforms. Quarterback under center. He's looking to pass. He's got it up. The coverage is there. 87 makes his third catch of the day. And he's brought down by number 43, Christian Trager. He had good coverage, but that 87, he is a Gronkowski out there. He is big fella, and he makes those catches.
It's a big kid.
First and 10 for Drake on the 50. Their best plays on offense today have been, come through the air. Good coverage. Oh, look at Trager. The pass is up. It's caught by number 2. The flag is there. Wow, he fought through the coverage. Christian made the press coverage right at the line. The throw is this beautiful lofted pass for 20 yards right in the arms of the receiver. Drake it moving the ball right now, again, through the air. Usually, Reading Rockets can get a pretty good pass rush off the edge. I'm not seeing that today. They're not getting to the quarterback before he gets it off. Blumenschein now getting a spell at corner at 7 on the left-hand side. On the right-hand side, it's Matt Hammond. There's the pass. The pass is up. It's deep. And another flag. McGrath got a bump on him on number 2.
That looked incidental to me.
Number 2 went down. Ref had to throw the flag. So that'll be 15 yards. They'll take it at the 15-yard line. Drake it moving the ball right now.
I think you got to let that one go.
The receiver did get a release on Jack Blumenschein over there in the left-hand end. Well, if I'm Drake and I keep passing the ball, I tell you what. Receivers split out left and right. Number 57 takes it. He's smacked by B.J. Jimolaro. He did not get the number of that truck that just hit him. He lost 6 yards on the play.
That's the easiest way to stop a pass. Blow through the line.
Well, big number 87's back on for Drakett. If I'm Redding, I find him. I get a guy on him right from the start, maybe 2. There's the snap. Oh, he falls down backwards. As he was backing up, trying to backpedal and get in position for a throw. I think he tripped on the feet of his center. And so that's a loss of 4 yards on the play. Back to the 25. Bring up 3rd and 20. In the I formation for Drake at 3rd and 20. 14 makes the pitch to number 15. He's caught in the backfield there by Duros, and he's smothered for a loss of 3 yards to the 28-yard line. Now 3rd and 23.
That looks like we gotta get down.
A whole lot, 4th and 23. Number 15 who made the tackles down, or I mean the run, the carry. Recognizing only 10 people in the audible, he called for one more. I was wondering if they were going to see that. So 4th and very long for Drakett. Quarterback number 14 in the shotgun. He's back to pass. He slides out to the left. He's got an arm. He's got a man downfield. It looks like the pass is caught by number 2.
Wow.
In a host of Rockets. There were 3 Rockets around him, and he catches the ball for a touchdown.
How did he come out with that?
I don't know. Great throw, great catch. Good concentration by number 2 to catch that ball. Makes it 32-12. Well, you know what this means, Adam? The Rockets get to go down and drive for another score.
Which is always fun.
23 Matt Gorman comes back in here on the line. He and Tom Keene in the A-gaps.
I think I know what the point of emphasis will be next week in practice.
Pass coverage?
I think so.
Well, it's good to face a team that shows you a different look that you haven't seen, challenge you in a new way. These Reading Rockets have high hopes and goals for the season. There's the snap. The kick is up, and it's up in the air, but does not have the distance. We got a flag after the play. Could be roughing. If that's the case, it's the Rockets' fourth or fifth penalty today, so that's another point of emphasis this week.
Yep.
Maybe a few burpees in store.
Looks like they're going to retry the kick.
Drake gets another try here. Conroy, number 44, comes on. Trying to get that two-pointer. There's the snap, and it's blocked. Blocked in there in the middle. Zupan was there, 65-12, Dan McGrath. So that keeps the score 32-12. Drake with about 2.5 remaining in the third quarter. Drake it kicking to Redding. They're here for an onside kick. They squib it up the middle. It's covered up by Jack Blumenschein at the 46-yard line. Rockets will take over first and 10. Jason Conroy in with the play here. First and 10 for the Rockets. In the backfield with, is that Chris Julie?
Yeah.
I think it is. One of the bigger backfields you'll see. Oh, half the Rockets jumped there. Something with the snap count. Back them up 5. First and 15 as they break the huddle. Conroy and Chuli in the backfield. There's a snap. Conroy takes himself over the right side. He's met there by one man, but he's able to drag the pile for a couple yards. Second down. I like how Coach Geiger gets everybody the chance to touch the ball at some point or another.
Yeah,
the makes for better football players.
Yeah, the kids put in a lot of hard work.
Yep.
It's nice to reward them when you can.
Right now we got Jake Ajander snapping the ball. Chris Julie in the backfield. He takes a snap over the right-hand side. He stiff arms one man. He's still on his feet over midfield. A good gainer there of about 7-8 yards. Bring up third down and manageable. Clock is winding down to about 20 seconds left in the third quarter. Don't always trust the scoreboard. All right, we have here the end of the third quarter with the score of the Rockets 32, Drake at 12. Rockets ball now, 3rd and 5. Conroy takes a snap, going over the right-hand side. He follows the block by Chris Julie. He breaks one arm tackle and gets through for the first down, down to the 43-yard line. Nice carry by Jason Conroy over right tackle. Julie in with the play. They break the huddle. There's a snap to Chuli over right tackle. Follows Jason Conroy's block. Spins away from one tackle. And he's pushing forward for a gain of seven yards. Nice carry by Chris Chuli. People in the stands commenting how, the ball security issues today have been great for Reading. They have not put it on the ground yet. I hope I didn't just jinx them.
Yeah. You know, that was probably a point of emphasis this week. We had five turnovers last week. It's tough to win a game that way.
Jack Blumenschein, 73, in with the play call this time from the 36-yard line. In the backfield with Chuli. There's a snap over the right tackle. He ducks and dives his way for a pickup of three or four, close to first down yardage.
Looks like it's going to be just short.
Third and half a yard.
Oh, no.
Oh, they're giving him the first down. All right. First down from the 32. The snap to Blumenschein. Over the right-hand side, he's following Chris Chuli.
There he goes.
He's on his way. He spins away from one man, gets down to the 13-yard line.
Nice pickup.
First down carry. The blocking was great on that play. This point in the game, the Rockets get a little predictable. Whoever gets the play call is going to get the ball. He's going to go over right tackle.
And it's working. Why change it?
It is working. Hammond with the ball. He follows the block of the right. Oh, he's spun down by big number 87.
Yeah, he come off the backside.
He no gain on the carry. That is a fearsome football player, number 87. Chuli with the play call here. Trevor Zupan's in the backfield with him. The snap to Chris Chuli. This time over left-hand tackle, and he's brought down by number 66 from the Drakett team. Blocking broke down on the left-hand side that time. So that'll set up a third and long for the Rockets. There's a snap. He's over the right-hand side. He's able to get a few yards positive, maybe three or four yards on the carry, down to the 17-and-a-half yard line. They bring up a fourth down for the Rockets with the clock winding down to 5 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter. Never any question that the Rockets are going to go for it. Chris Julian with the play, number 84.
You think they let him drop back on this one?
I wish. I'd like to see him throw that deep pass over the middle. I don't think that's the play call, though.
Oh, come on, Geiger. Let him do it.
Uh-oh. Got a flag. Could be a delay. Fourth and about 18 for the Rockets, fourth and 18 or 19. The shuffle of players in and out is causing a little bit of confusion. From the 23 as the referee winds the clock. De Silva and Duross are talking to Coach Geiger. You may see a rollout pass here. Break the huddle. Come on, guys. Get up to the line quickly. BJ on the right-hand side. There's the snap. Oh, the fake, the end around to BJ Gemellaro on the left-hand side. He stiff arms one man to get away. He's brought down, but it's a horse collar tackle at the 10. The flag from the ref, he was all over it. That's going to give the Rockets new life. The pickup on the play of about 10-plus yards would not have had first down yardage, but with the penalty, the Rockets still have the ball.
Looks like that was number 87.
Well, sometimes kids get a little frustrated to be on the losing end, 20-point here. Good player like that gets a little frustrated. Rockets ball, first and goal from the 5. Duross, McGrath, De Silva in the backfield. There's a snap, it's high. Oh, Brendan covers it up at the 15. Making it a little harder for ourselves. Second and goal from the 15. Rockets ball, second and 15 now. There's a snap and the handoff. It's on the ground. Brendan covers it up at the 15. On the handoff, didn't get it cleanly. That clock is winding down to 2.5 as the Rockets eat up most of the fourth quarter here on this drive. Third and goal from the 15. Evan Long motions to the right and the sweep right. Everybody's out there. McGrath has the ball. He breaks through one man. He's there for the touchdown. He reaches out. You could see that play developing. Drake, it was not going to have enough defenders for all the Rockets streaming around the right-hand side. Touchdown makes it 38-12 Rockets. Well, these kicked extra points in Pop Warner are always very exciting. Brendan De Silva on the hold. Christian Trauger to try and get through the uprights. He gets it up, and it is good.
It's good.
Right down the middle for 2. Good kick by Christian Trauger. Makes it 40-12. Under 2 minutes to go in the game. I think the Rockets have learned that it's more fun to give up a couple scores so more guys get to score in the game.
I mean, they may not make the coaches happy, though.
Yeah. One of the Pop Warner slaughter rules is that you kick off from the 20 rather than the 40. So Christian Trauger here to line up and give it a boot. 5 on either side of him here on this kick. Oh, it's a huge kick. And the refs blow the whistle. Maybe they weren't set.
Had a few issues with them here today.
Yeah. Hasn't been clean.
Not just the bad flags, but a lot of time taken to make calls and
right.
Set the ball.
Yep, you're right. You're right. And the chains and getting these things set up.
Who are we to judge, though? We have the easy job, right?
All right, he's going to set to kick it again, Christian Trauger. That's a good kick, not quite as far as the last one, down to the 40. Number 8 grabs it. Number 9, Evan Long, tackles him along with Dominic DiCrescenzo. Still on his feet, though.
Jeez.
Wow, he's Blow the whistle, goodness. So he's brought down at the 31-yard line by the whole team. From the 32-yard line, Drake, it breaks the huddle. Minute and a half remaining, down 28. Quarterback number 14 back in the backfield with backs on either side of him.
Looking for another pass here.
He's got a good arm. Oh, but 57 takes it. And he also has a good arm, but it's intercepted by number 12, Dan McGrath. He takes a knee. Great catch back there. Great safety coverage. We're not fooled by the play.
Good job just getting down, you know.
That's right. No need to make a spectacular return. Probably if Redding wants to right now, they could go in the victory formation. The referees drop a yellow flag for some reason. All right, well, it looks as though that's the game. The referees have thrown in the towel, I guess. Your final, the Redding Rockets 40 and Drake at 12. A great performance by the Redding Rockets coming off of last week's effort. And we're back in the win column at 3-1.
Yeah, it was a nice comeback game for these guys. Come out, they played loose, they executed. They held their blocks this week. So
the blocks
held on to the ball.
They did not turn the ball over. And, you know, when you're owning the line of scrimmage, it makes it a lot easier for your team to execute. And that we saw that again today. Good game plan by the coaches. So until next week, this is Josh Blumenschein and Adam Hooker signing off. Thank you for watching Redding Rockets football.